This is the video for Unit 7, Lesson 3, Properties of Logs. So the goal is going to be to identify properties of logs, to condense a logarithmic expression, to expand a log expression, and then to evaluate if needed with the base change or change of base formula. So we looked at logs in our last few sections. So they're closely tied with exponentials, right? That's the inverse that we can use to work with exponentials. But logs also have lots of properties that we can use, similar when we learned Ikbad expressions in Algebra 1, right? We can make things longer, we can make things shorter, or expand or condense. We can also multiply and divide. So the product property is the first one we're going to end up seeing. So this is if I'm taking log base b of m times n, that's the same as taking log base b of m plus log base b of n. So I can rewrite it as two logs with addition, and as long as it's the same base. The second one is the quotient property. So if I'm dividing two logs, or dividing two values with base b, I could do that as just subtraction. So log base b of m minus log base b of n, that would be a way I can rewrite the division, or vice versa if I wanted to condense. The last one is the power property. So if I'm taking log base b of m to the n, I could rewrite this by moving the exponent to the front and it becomes like a coefficient. And this sometimes makes it nice if I want to solve a problem. It makes it a little easier to work with. So the first one we're looking at is if I wanted to expand this out. So just to kind of give you an idea, if I have log base 5 of 2/3, that's the same as rewriting it if I wanted to expand as two separate logs. So I have its division, so it's really the same as doing log base 5 of the numerator, which is 2, minus log base 5 of the denominator, or the bottom, which is 3. You don't have to use a parenthesis. I just use it just to make my work a little cleaner, so I don't type it in wrong, but it helps if you know that you're making a lot of little mistakes, like the 5 looks like a 52 when the 5 and the 2 are together. Parentheses can kind of help you keep your work straight. The second one, same thing. So I have this expression that's being multiplied. And so when we write this out, this is the same as log base 6 of 2, it's multiplication, plus log base 6 of m to the 5th, plus log base 6 of n to the 3rd. And then, so we're multiplying, so we're rewriting it as addition. And then we have these exponents that we can rewrite so we don't have to have an exponent in our log. So log base 6 of 2 stays the same. The 5 can actually come out front. 5 log of 6 of m. And then the 3 can come out front. And this would be, if I wanted to expand it, this would be this means these are equivalent statements. So it's the same as what we originally had. We just expanded it out. Another skill that we have is we could actually condense or rewrite as a single log. So when we rewrite this one out, this one we're using the same base, because if we didn't, we'd have to, you know, we wouldn't be able to do it, or we'd have to do some rewriting. We're using addition. So it's the same as multiplication. So this is the same as if I was to rewrite it, though, the first one doesn't have a coefficient, but the second one does. So I might, before I can put them together, I'm going to move this 1/2, rewrite it as an exponent because we don't want any coefficients. If I'm going to do x to the 1/2, we saw in our radical unit, that's a rational exponent. That's the same as, and this is base 5, that's the same as doing the square root. So log base 5, and then this would be the square root of x. And then now that we have each of these simplified, we can put them together. So I could put them now in the same log as multiplication. And this would be my final answer. The last one, we have 8 times log base 3 of 2 minus 5 log base of 3, log base 3 of x. So I'm going to rewrite it. So this would be log base 3 of 2 to the 8th minus, I'm going to rewrite this 5, log base 3 of x to the 5th. And now that I'm rewriting it, I'm going to always go from left to right. So this is subtraction, so I can rewrite it as division. So log base 3 of 2 to the 8th over x to the 5th. You can rewrite 2 to the 8th if you really want to. It'd be 128, but you don't really have to. Sometimes the question might ask for it, but if it doesn't, it's really more just teacher preference. The next thing we're going to look at is talking about the change of base formula. So some calculators already do this, or maybe you have a processing system on your calculator that you don't even need to know base change. But some of us have calculators that our calculator only can do the natural log, and it can only do log base 10. So this is kind of a nice property that if we have to do, let's say, log base 4 of 9, we can use this. So what this says is that log base b of m is log of m over log of b. So we're going to use, this works with any log, but I'm going to use base 10. So because base 10 is just simply using the log key, which all calculators have the log key if it's scientific or graphing. So if I want to evaluate this, you can, unless your calculator has a special processing, you're going to see you don't have log base 4 on here. So what we can do, if I want to find log base 4 of 9, that's the same as doing log of 9. So log of, like, the value being evaluated, and over the base, log base 4. So my calculator maybe doesn't know, can't, like for mine, doesn't do base 4, but we could actually do it in our calculator using change of base or base change. So if I do log base 9, I'm going to close that parenthesis, divided by log base 4. And if I do two decimal places, 1.58 would be my log. So what that means is that 4 to the 1.58 power is equal to 9, which actually makes sense, right? Because 4 to the second is 16, 4 to the 1 is 4, so you knew it's somewhere between 1 and 2. For number 6, same thing. So this would be, you could see my base is 9. So it's always log of the value over log of the base. And again, you can do this with natural log too. So if I was to go ahead and put this in, I would say log of 12, closing the parenthesis, log of 9. And then I can get the actual value. So this is different than the quotient property that we just saw. This is more if I need the actual value for that log to solve in a problem. So 1.13 would be my answer for that. If you have any questions, you could ask in class, sign up for T-Bolt time, or go to the center.